Hello everyone, and welcome to another video. Today, I'm going to show you how to create realistic grass in 3ds Max using Multiscatter, so let's begin. I'm going to use two types of grass, low and high, by Max3. First of all, we need to create multiscatters. I'm going to create two scatters for low and for high grass. So let's start from the low one. Open scatter settings and pick the objects you want to spread. Then you need to pick the surface on which the grass will grow. Now, you need to enter a value of max count. It shows the number of spread objects. The seed changes objects' position randomly. Max preview shows how many objects will be displayed in the scene. Don't set too high value, it may slow down your scene. Instead of a surface, you can also choose the line along which objects will be spread. If you choose the line in border spline slot, grass will grow only inside or outside this line. So let's make our grass more realistic. For this, we need to make it more random. Scale value makes the objects change its size. You just need to choose from what to what. I usually choose from 80 to 100 or from 80 to 120. Then go to rotate section and enter 360 degrees on the z-axis. You can also enter move value and objects will change their location relative to the axis. So let's check our grass on the interactive render. Now we're going to set the high grass scatter. Pick objects to spread as we did it first time and pick the surface. Then enter max count and max preview values and change seed value if you need. To make our grass more interesting, we will make grass pattern. For this, we need a map like this one or you can use another. If you wanna get this map, you need just follow me on Instagram and text me to DM the word grass. The link to my Instagram in the description. You can change size of the map here. So let's put the map to the slot. Grass spreads in places where the white color is. You can also rotate this map and change the grass pattern. To make the grass thinner or thicker, you need to change the value of output amount of the map. The higher the value, the thicker the grass. Thank you. Now let's set the parameters of scaling and rotation to make the grass more random. And let's check the interactive render. So that's it. I hope it was helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching and goodbye.